Hello everyone, welcome back to Neerja Education, and if you have not subscribed our channel yet, please do it quickly. So today in this session we are going to learn a very interesting topic, and which is division of fractions of your class 7th maths lesson number 2, fraction. My dear children, as you have seen my all parts, I hope so, in that we had discussion about type of fractions, how to add fractions, how to subtract fraction, how to multiply fraction, and this is the turn for how to divide fraction. If you want to get connected with this topic so easily, it is very necessary for you to see the third part of this section, in that I have explained about multiplication of fraction. And if you are knowing multiplication of fraction, then only you are going to do division, because here we are going to use multiplication as well, that we will be seeing. Now, before moving to division of fraction, first thing we should learn is reciprocal of a fraction. Now, how to find reciprocal of fraction? It is very easy. To make reciprocal of a fraction, write denominator as numerator and numerator as denominator. Now, this is very confusing. Let's see by example. Suppose I am writing a fraction a by b. If I want to write the reciprocal of this, it is b upon a. You have to write numerator as denominator and denominator as numerator. That means, if you want to find reciprocal of any number, what you have to do is reverse. Suppose 1 upon 2, then reciprocal of 1 upon 2 is 2 upon 1. And one thing you need to remember over here, if you are going to multiply fraction and its reciprocal, then answer of product is always 1. So we can also state like product of two reciprocal fraction is always 1. So this is how you can find the reciprocal of any fraction. Now let's see how to divide the fractions. Now let's see how to divide two fractions first. Here we are going to take two fractions. Suppose first one I am taking a upon b and another one is c upon d. We are going to divide the fraction with each other. This first term we can call as dividend, and this one we can call as divisor. Now, to divide any two fraction number, you need to put dividend, that means first term a by b as it is. Second thing we are going to do is, we are going to change this division symbol in multiplication. And if we are going to change something, we must should pay also for that. So we are going to pay is this, we are going to convert our divisor in reciprocal. What is the reciprocal of c by d? It is d upon c. Now this is a upon b multiply d upon c, and in our previous part we have learnt how to multiply two fraction, a multiply by d and b multiply by c. So this is the way you can multiply any two fraction. You need to follow the same procedure. What? You need to put the dividend as it is. If you don't want to remember as dividend and divisor, you can also remember like first term and second term. We need to put our first term as it is. We are going to convert this division sign into multiplication, and for that we need to convert our second term, that means our divisor, into reciprocal. After that, it will directly change into multiplication sum, and we are knowing how to multiply fractions. Now let's see different kind of example and understand it more clearly. First one is 15 upon 30 divide by 2. As you can see, here one is fraction number and another one is whole number. But don't worry, we are knowing how to convert whole number into fraction. We can write this 2 as 2 upon 1. Now let's do the sum. 15 upon 30 divide by 2 upon 1. As we have seen, what we need to do? We need to put first term as it is. That means let's put 15 by 30 as it is. Now we need to convert this division sign into multiplication sign, and for that we need to write reciprocal of this 2 by 1, and reciprocal of 2 by 1 is 1 upon 2. Now what we need to do? We need to multiply 15 multiplied by 1 and 30 multiplied by 2. As you can see, here we can directly cut 15 to the 30. What left? 1 over here, 2 multiplied by 2 is 4. Now let's see another example, 2 by 5 divided by 15 upon 3. As you can see, both the number are fraction number. Let's put first term as it is, 2 by 5, division will change into multiplication, reciprocal of this, 3 upon 15, 2 multiplied by 3, 5 multiplied by 15. Here also we can cut 3 5s are 15. What left? 2 upon 5 multiplied by 5. 2 upon 5 multiplied by 5 is equal to 25. So, in other word, we can also state our division of fraction like this. Division is to multiply our dividend with the reciprocal of divisor. That means this dividend, we are going to multiply it with reciprocal of division. Now let's see another examples. As you can see over here, this both the fractions are given in the form of mixed fraction. That means now we are going to see how to divide mixed fraction. And to divide mixed fraction, first thing we are going to do is we are going to convert this both the mixed fraction into improper, and then we will proceed as we have seen. Let's convert. First one is 5 into 2 by 3. If we are going to convert this into improper fraction, it will be 3 multiplied by 5, 15, 15 plus 2, 17, 17 by 3, divide by 9 ones are 9, 9 plus 1, 10 by 9. We need to put the first term as it is, convert this division into multiplication, write the reciprocal. Reciprocal of 10 by 9 is 9 upon 10. Now let's do multiplication. 3 multiplied by 10. Here we can cut directly, 3 3's are 9. So what is left? 17 multiplied by 3 divided by 10. 17 3's are 51 upon 10. Now let's see fourth example. 2 divided by 2 into 4 by 7. To proceed further, we need to write this both the term as the improper fraction. This 2 can be written as 2 by 1 divided by 7 to the 14, 14 plus 4, 18 by 7. Put the first term as it is, convert division into multiplication, write the reciprocal of this term, which is 7 upon 18. 2 multiplied by 7, 18 multiplied by 1 is equal to 18. Here we can cut. 2 9's are 18. What left? 7 upon 9. So my dear student, this way you can divide any fraction numbers. What you need to do is, you need to remember just process. Then if mixed fractions are given, then you have to convert into improper, and then same process you have to do. So here we are going to end our session for today. Thank you.